Good evening, everyone. My name is Joshua Yearout, and I'm going to give you a quick presentation about expanding the WIC program. To expand the WIC program, we need to know what WIC is, why it works, and the association that maternal nutrition and infant health have with each other. So, maternal nutrition status is essential and crucial for fetal development and infant health. There, one cannot exist without the other. Maternal malnutrition leads to adverse outcomes, like low birth weight, and increased non-communicable disease risk. That would be your gestational diabetes, your cardiovascular diseases, and then long-term health issues that go along with that, obesity and the such. And then nutrition during pregnancy affects the lifelong health and productivity of the baby. Anything that you were deficient in, like iron, for example, folate, can have lifelong implications and risks if you did not have adequate nutrition during gestation. So what is WIC? Well, it stands for Women, Infants, and Children. It was created by the USDA in 1972, and it tries to address the nutritional needs of low-income pregnant women, infants, and children. Note, you don't have to be a woman to get WIC benefits. If you're a single dad, a grandparent, you may also qualify for the WIC program. It provides nutritious foods, education, nutritional education, breastfeeding information, and education on healthy eating and healthcare referrals. So why does it work? Well, WIC provides specific food packages to meet the nutrient needs of pregnant women, their babies, and the children up to age 5. It addresses key nutritional deficiencies, such as in America, we've added folate to a lot of cereals, a lot of different products, and that helps with decreasing the amount of neurotube deficiencies that babies are born with. It also offers personalized nutrition assessments, education, and counseling to participants. It empowers women to make healthier food choices when they're at the grocery store. And it also includes support and counseling for breastfeeding mothers. It normalizes breastfeeding, which hasn't really, which has been more normalized in the last decade or so than it was when formula was first being produced. It also boosts local economies. It increases the demand for healthy foods. Whole grains, fruits, vegetables are appearing in more smaller grocery and convenience stores. The policies and food packages are based on the latest nutritional science and public health research that ensures that WIC's offerings can reflect current health recommendations. They get that, talking about RDIs and the such like that. So they're also, WIC also is associated with higher births. For those who are in the program, higher birth weights, that includes reductions in the low birth weight and premature deliveries, and improves maternal nutrition during pregnancy. We touched on this a little bit, but it also transforms local neighborhood food environments by increasing the availability of nutritious foods. Again, those fresh fruits and vegetables, reduced fat milks, and whole grain products. It also allows for soy products and other products that you may not be able to get because you don't have the means to do so. WIC requires... requirements have led to healthier food options in both the large stores, but also the smaller convenience stores and the local corner stores. It elevates the nutritional profile of communities, so it takes it brings in more nutritionally dense food rather than caloric dense food. And then the nutrition education that it provides empowers families for to make more informed food choices, and then it tries to foster that culture of health. So what I think should be done to expand WIC is that we need to increase the age limit for children. There are a lot of children out there that that are food insecure, and it doesn't stop at 5. So proposed extending the eligibility to children up to 13 years of age. And this is meant to address the energy deficits during crucial growth spurts and crucial brain development phases. The average 10 to 11 year old, when going through a growth spurt, their caloric intake increases to 18 to 2200 kcals per day. And then also, we need to raise the income eligibility threshold. And I would like to suggest that we increase the income requirement to $60,000 of gross income. That currently is set at about $45,000 per year for a family of 3. So bringing it up and making it more available to people who are maybe make more money but not able to still purchase those commodities. And then doing so, again, will broaden everything, but broaden everyone who can come into the program, but also it fosters, again, that culture of health, of healthy food choices. And so to conclude, just going again, WIC's role is pivotal in connecting maternal nutrition with infant health, and then just overall community well-being. And beyond tackling malnutrition, WIC also fosters a culture of a healthier, more resilient future, just with its, all of the education that it can provide. And then lastly, investing in WIC is an investment in a stronger and more prosperous society. So I hope that you've heard me, and we can move forward with this.